Hello, everybody. Venom Lion here with coffee. Amazing coffee. And today we got another Halo 3 reaction video. Looking at the playlist, I'm not sure exactly what the next videos will be about, but we're gonna kick things off today with the Vidoc on the 7th day. Let's go. Before going though, huge thanks again to Phoenix Vax for his playlist, of course.
Hi, I'm Luke from Bungie.
And I'm Shishka.
And today we're here to talk about July 7th, Bungie Day.
But, it's not the 7th.
Right, okay. It's not actually our anniversary at this exact moment, but last year on July 7th, these seven dudes climbed into a shoebox together.
Shoebox? What does this have to do with Bungie Day?
Shishka, please. 7th day, 7th month, 7th column, Bungie Day.
I'm so confused right now. Where am I?
What? Independence has us driving toward becoming a multi-game studio, and the first thing that we're going to announce
we're not announcing anything yet.
But, dude, it's Bungie Day. Well, okay, it's a few days before Bungie Day. What can we announce?
Interesting that he said a multi-game studio, because like I don't know how, if you guys know, but like having a multi-game studio is quite a feat, because when you start out as a studio, if you're independent and stuff, you usually focus on one game at a time, right? So you spend all production, you put out a game, and then you start, you know, on the next one. But if you are a multi-game studio, that means there's more than one game in development at one time. And that's a huge logistic pain in the ass, because like, it's not just like doubling the production. You need to have like senior people and creative directors and everything that can do that job. Like, it's not just as simple as being like, we're going to hire a bunch more designers and writers and, you know, and artists, and they're going to make that. No, you need the leadership to do it. So being a multi-game studio, it's big.
The thing we're here to talk about?
We're here to talk about something?
Yeah, Cold Storage.
Huh?
A remake of Halo Combat Evolved map Chill Out, available on Xbox Live Marketplace for...
200 points!
It's free, moron. Bungie and Microsoft are releasing Cold Storage on July 7th for free.
Right.
We're going to change all the text in the game to let folks know that the Legendary playlists now require all DLC.
Wait, so after Bungie Day, Cold Storage becomes a part of the Legendary map pack and I have to pay for it?
The map is going to be free and it's always going to be free.
So tell me if I've got this right. On Bungie Day, I can download Cold Storage for free from Xbox Live Marketplace.
What the hell are you doing?
Aww. After Bungie Day, I can download Cold Storage for free.
Correct.
It's always free.
Yeah, absolutely.
Then, when I want to play it in Halo 3...
That's a pretty cool way to market your free content, like with Machinima from in-game.
Hey, just a second, Junior.
That's pretty cool.
Oh, Junior.
So I'll have to have downloaded the Heroic map pack, which is free, purchased the Legendary map pack, and then downloaded the free Cold Storage, and then I'm good to go.
Yeah, you got it. That's not so hard, is it?
That sounds kind of complicated, to be honest.
As you can see, Cold Storage is a forerunner research facility that has had an unfortunate contamination outbreak.
Whoa, that's a flood pure form. Does it come to life during CTF and act as a super defender? Where's the BR spawn?
Chill out about the BR spawn, and next you're gonna ask me about the Halo 1 pistol, aren't you?
Well, actually, I was.
And now you wanna know if it's a perfect pour.
Well, yeah, and what the hell is Vic doing here?
He is painting in the fun, Chad. I know that you're like a junior designer and you don't know about painting in the fun yet.
Hey, I'm all about fun.
You cannot simply give what I can take. Speaking of taking it, Lars, let's talk about all the things that are different in Chill Out.
Halo 1 and Halo 3 are obviously different games. The fact that he can jump quite a bit higher, all those subtle differences make it pretty apparent that we had to change some of the jumps or the railing.
Yeah.
Oh, suck it, Lars.
Very, very interesting stuff there, guys. Yeah. Each games are unique, right? And even though you might think that Halo and Halo 3 are similar, there are major differences in the way that the game handles itself, right? So very interesting. Yeah, you just cannot like port a map as is. Most of the time, the jumps is not the same, right? So like you have to modify some things there. That is very interesting. Very interesting.
First, you keep going to that one spot over and over. Is that all you did in Halo 1 too, was camp there?
It's really designed for a small free-for-all style slayer game.
And also, like, Halo 3 have power-ups, right? Like, equipment that you can use?
Almost anywhere within a few seconds, so it makes games really hectic.
So, yeah, you have to think where you're gonna put those in that map.
You die a lot in this game.
You die a lot.
Well, we were going to call it
Classic.
Cold Sore at first, but...
And then we realized that that just wasn't going
to
work.
We kind of took it as a means to sort of explore the Forerunner style. The whole idea was kind of what if there was a sort of medical Forerunner? A lot of, like, the detail work and the paneling is something that's completely unique.
Hey, look, does this look like a poop?
It does.
The weapon layout is actually very faithful to chill out, with the one exception being the pistol not being here and replaced with the battle rifle.
Hey, Lars?
Yeah?
Stand still for a second.
I will.
Okay.
Oh, God.
Hey, what is this?
Don't mind him. He doesn't do anything.
What do you mean he's doing something right now? He's shining a big freaking light in my eyes.
Yeah, if you stare at him like that instead of looking at the dudes trying to kill you...
Can I have a flamethrower?
You can, but only a forge.
I want a flamethrower, man.
Ugh.
Flamethrower is such an awesome multiplayer weapon. I love it.
You go, Vic. Oh,
thanks.
There's soccer out. Balls and everything, too.
We came up with blockers for this area, so if you want to play Chill Out Classic...
I dropped my car keys down.
There's soccer balls.
Fusion coils and teleporters. We got a mongoose. I don't know if you'd ever want to play cold storage with a ghost, but hey, you can.
This is more of a competitive map.
Alright, I'm taking that.
Ow.
Please enjoy yourselves. It's a present from Bungie to you.
Cold
That's pretty cool.
Cold storage will be available for free beginning on July 7th. It's a thank you to our fans for being oh so supportive.
How cool would it be if on Bungie Day, Microsoft decided to lower the price of the Legendary map pack from 800 points to 600 points?
What do you know? That's what they're gonna do.
Isn't that neat, kids?
Luke, who the hell says neat?
Oh, you know what we forgot?
What's that?
There's gonna be a whole playlist, you asshole. You're the playlist designer.
7-player free-for-all. It's gonna be awesome. Yeah, coffee?
Coffee.
Sweet.
Coffee, man. That's pretty cool. Neat trailer. It's pretty funny also that they use the actual people working at Bungie to make these trailers. That's fun, you know? That's fun. All right, so next up we have the Halo 3 Mythic trailer. No idea what that is, boys. Probably like a map pack?
Looking for something to add some spice to your multiplayer? Have we got the maps for you. Introducing the brand new Mythic map pack, brought to you by Microsoft Game Studios and Bungie, the makers of the Man Cannon and the minds behind the shield door. All three spaces in the Mythic map pack are filled to the brim with bone-crunching, brain-jarring multiplayer awesome sauce.
Damn, what the fuck?
Chasing new achievements and the sweet hidden skulls you need to get started on your road to recon. Check out Sandbox, the ultimate Forge playground. They say, if you build it, they will come. Well, we say, if you build it, come get some. The ruins of Sandbox are the perfect place for some frenzied Team Slayer and frantic capture the flag action. First, you take a barren desert surrounded by some rolling sand dunes, add in a chopper, a warthog, a couple mongooses, and you're ready for some vehicular manslaughter.
Huh.
Tell your infantry friends to hold still while you drop a tank on their heads. Achievement unlocked! But wait, there's more! Some people say the sky is the limit. Well, not on Sandbox. Have a look at the Sky Bubble, a supersized space that begs to be forged. Build your arena high above the dunes where vertigo never felt so good. Before your friends get their bearings, blast them off the edge with a burst of superheated plasma and watch them fall. Take five! But we're not done yet! If you got the kill balls, step into the crypt. It's time to separate the genetically enhanced super soldiers from the boys in a knockdown,
What's
drag
happening?
Out, free-for-all brawl. And once you clear the floor, grab your hammer and get ready for some swinging. It's crypt ball time! Remember, what happens in the crypt stays in the crypt. Celebratory crouching option. But wait, that's not all! The amazing Mythic map pack! Looking to throw down deep inside Covenant space? Check out Assembly for those intimate Team Slayer matches. And we're not talking R&B and sparkling grape juice here. Assembly is built straight up for some magical multiplayer action. Battle Rifle, Covenant Carbine, you know the deal. As a very special gift to you, we're adding an orbital at no extra charge. With the Mythic Map Pack, you get 3 times the forge space, and you'll have 3 times the fun.
Oh, look at that.
As an added bonus, with every Mythic Map Pack ordered, we're throwing in a 7-wood absolutely free. Be a pro, TTO.
What the fuck?
There's no shipping and handling fees, and you don't need to send a check or money order. Just head over to the Xbox Live Marketplace on April 9th, 2009, and the Mythic Map Pack can be yours for a one-time payment of 800 Microsoft points. You've mastered Hero. You've beaten Legendary. Now it's time to put your skills to the test with the Mythic Map Pack. Warning, downloading and playing Halo 3's Mythic Map Pack may result in hours of prolonged fun. Do not use the Mythic Map Pack if you're allergic to discovering hidden skulls or any new achievements or wearing recon armor. If you experience a discomforting or persistent urge to use the Forge Create awesome custom content instead of eating, sleeping, or bathing, do not be alarmed. This is a typical side effect of using the Mythic Map Pack. If for any reason your desire to download and play the Mythic Map Pack is anything less than insatiable, please contact your physician immediately. Bungie, Microsoft Game Studios, Halo 3 and the Mythic Map Pack are not responsible for any lapses in employment or relationship issues with your life partner. When Step 7 is inevitably completed, signifying Bungie's completion of the world domination plan, descends from the sky directly into the sun, courtesy of a giant slaying consider this your one and only warning, Halo 3 and hardware not included with the Mythic Map Pack. Don't make us kick your ass.
What an amazing trailer. I like the style of that one. Also interesting, they seem to like focus a lot of like the forge capabilities of those maps. And that looks interesting. That looks interesting. All right, Bungle teaser trailer. What the fuck is that? Probably some other multiplayer stuff, right? But the real fight hasn't even begun to be it's time to finish what you began. What? Okay. Equipment, yes. Changes, everything, yep, it does. Oh, look at that. I like that a lot. So is that like a teaser for new options in the forge? Bungie Ultimate Ninja Gaming League Extreme. Okay. I like how the weapons are displayed there. Not sure what this is about, still. Is that a fucking ninja sword? What? Is that cosmetics? All right, not sure what that's about. That wasn't pleasant. Okay, GoPro, yeah, that's probably like a... some sort of like MLG gaming league or something. Interesting. Halo, 10 years. Oh, interesting.
But this is one of the coolest I've ever seen. This game is going to ship early next year from Bungie, and we're going to see, for the first time, Halo.
Wow, it does look dated now. Gaming evolves so rapidly, guys. It is insane.
I feel like I am forgetting something. What was it?
Of course, they gotta see Halo.
Hey everybody, so I'm Jason. I'm one of the co-founders of Bungie and the lead on Halo. I've got Joe Staten with me here.
I am going to be playing Halo in the flesh on the Xbox. On behalf of the whole Halo team, thanks a lot for coming, and welcome to Halo on the Xbox.
Now that is such a cool moment to experience, man. When your game gets announced... Nothing beats that, man. Nothing beats that.
So, you beat the Halo demo. Not bad, soldier. Not bad at all.
Chan-san!
But are you ready to take the next step? Halo, Combat Evolved. Buy one. Heck, buy two. That's an order, soldier.
Buy them all. Just buy them all, man. All of them. And I do get, like... why a lot of you guys are really in love with that series. There's nothing like growing up with a series, right?
Just getting together with people, being able to, you know, talk about, oh, it was so great when you killed me with that rocket. I didn't even know it was coming.
Fire your weapon!
Because for some of you guys, you've been playing Halo for 20 years now.
You know what he'd expect.
That's crazy.
What he'd want us to do.
They let me pick. Did I ever tell you that? Choose whichever Spartan I wanted.
Alright, so this looks to me like it's a kind of a recap of the franchise, which we already did before. So I'm gonna skip ahead a bit.
We could use this to make movies.
Bernie!
Yeah. We could totally use this to make movies.
Don't worry, boys.
Fucking love these boys, man.
For everybody. Master Chief.
I should listen to their podcast again.
Wait, what? What am I? What am I lying?
Just half
left. Yeah.
I need everybody to line up their groins.
Wait, hang on.
Hell, I should probably try to watch Red vs. Blue, cause like I know Halo now. Though I'm not even sure if Red vs. Blue has anything to do with Halo. Probably, like, I know, like, they've probably, like, upgraded their storytelling and everything over the years. I really don't know. Oh, man. Just seeing their studio like that, I miss being in the studio, man. This fucking pandemic. Working from home, it fucking sucks, man. I don't like it at all.
Hey, Bungie!
Oh my god. That's in 2007, right? Guitar Hero 2 is displayed there. Sims 2, Bon Voyage. Ooh, so French. Oh man, that is interesting. I've worked on a Guitar Hero as a video game tester way back in the day.
You guys have made like last 7
I worked on Warriors of Rock.
All right, you ready?
One of the last ones, I think.
And prepare to drop.
Prepare to drop. Is that ODST? Wait. I think it is. Some of you guys told me not to watch anything about ODST to keep the surprise. So you know what? There's like less than a minute left to the trailer, so I will skip it. That looked interesting though. Oh man, I can't wait for ODST. You guys have told me some stuff about ODST that I'm really curious about. I know we don't play Chief, but a lot of you guys mentioned like how I will like that game. So, you know, I'm curious about that. I'm curious about that a lot. All right, let's go to the legendary ending of Halo 3.
Chief, can you hear me? I thought I'd lost you, too.
All right, okay, so this is after the credits, I think. When we're lost.
What happened?
I'm not sure. When Halo fired, it shook itself to pieces. Did a number on the Ark. The portal couldn't sustain itself. We made it through just as it collapsed. Well, some of us made it.
That is a nice ending to the trilogy, I find.
But you did it. Truth and the Covenant, the Flood, it's finished.
It's finished.
I'll drop a beacon, but it'll be a while before anyone finds us. Years, even.
The time of a new development cycle.
Wake me when you need me.
It's funny because, like, knowing that Bungie didn't plan on making, like, the next game about Chief, you can read a lot about, like, almost as if, like, Bungie themselves are, like, we're sending Master Chief off, right? Now that I know that, I read that cutscene very differently, and that's very interesting. Like, it works for the story they're trying to tell, but it also works metaphorically about the character and the game. Yeah, that is cool. That is cool. So the legendary stuff is probably now? Right? Because I haven't seen anything different so far. Did I see that in the ending? I don't think so. All right, so I didn't think I noticed anything different, except maybe the last shot where you see a planet and it's bluish light. Not sure what was that about. Did I miss something about the legendary ending? Because, like, I don't know. I didn't notice anything very different. You guys let me know, because I'm kind of confused about that one, not gonna lie. Oh, the different funny lines in Sierra 117 with our boy Johnson.
Chief, wait! The Arbiter's with us!
Come on now. We've got enough to worry about without you two trying to kill each other.
Were it so easy. We must go. The brutes have our scent.
Then they must love the smell of green.
Smell of green.
We must go. The brutes have our scent.
Then they must love the smell of hero.
Smell of hero? Ew. Must not smell good.
We must go. The brutes have our scent.
Then they must love the smell of badass.
Right. That I like that one.
We must go. The brutes have our scent.
Then they must love the scent of testosterone.
Hell yeah. The smell of balls.
We must go. The brutes have our scent.
They must love the scent of a real man.
All right, kind of like synonyms right there, like testosterone, real man, you know. All right.
We must go. The brutes have.
There's a lot of these.
Then they must love the smell of badass. And I left a little present for you, Arbiter, and I'm walking away.
What?
We must go.
How many of these lines are there?
They must love the smell of Bulgari. Yeah, I'm doing a little product placement.
I gotta get paid too.
What? Okay. All right, next we're adding into the Bungie intro high quality. Oh, right, like the actual studio logo when you boot the game. Okay, and also like that. All right, let me rewind a bit, okay? Yep, you see like the holographic effect there on the studio's logo. Oh, and right there again at the end. And see, that's something that I don't know for you guys, but I always, always really enjoy that. Because like, most of the time, like when you boot a game, depending on the style of game, like the theme and everything, like the studios will do like a different type of intro for their logo. And I've always thought that was super cool. Like, I don't know why, but like if you have like a Greek team game, you will have like kind of like a Greek presentation. Like same thing with Halo, right? Like Bungie has the holographic kind of like effects and everything. That's cool. I've always really enjoyed that. Oh, we got an ad for a game that I have no interest in. Great. The main menu, music. Interesting. Oh, I like that telescreen. Man, it's such a shame that the MCC doesn't have that. Because that puts you in the mood. Look at that. That is such a better menu than the MCC one. Like you can just sit there and watch it, you know, and it's just cool. All right, so this goes on for 5 minutes, so I won't sit there and watch everything, but I will skip ahead to see what they show us here. That's cool. Seeing the spaceships. All right, so it basically shows the road and the huge like crater there. That is a cool main menu screen for sure. And we got the loading screen of the game too. Interesting. Man, that is so 2000s. I've had the same comments with Halo 1 and 2. Yep. Yeah, like a huge graphic. Because nowadays you have like basically a huge black screen and just like a tiny image at the bottom that moves. That's the Halo being constructed. All right, that makes sense. That makes a lot of sense. Also satisfying to watch, like. Yes. The ring is complete. I like that.
Le Nissan Kicks vous permet de bouger à votre rythme. Peu importe le rythme.
All right, French boy. Shut the fuck up. All right, guys. So that will be all for today. Next episode, I'm going to react to the 3 videos of a villainous toaster containing a lot of funny dialogue. So I'm really hyped about that. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, subscribe, and I will be seeing you guys in the next video. Have a good one.